You're on to your second company, and it's doing very well. If you look back now at the last 10 to 15 years, what was your greatest accomplishment in that period of time?
I would say in the past 15 years, people maybe on the outside would say what I did with advertising.com, because the chapter has been written and told and said, it was probably my greatest accomplishment. For me personally, I feel the journey I'm on with Videology is my greatest accomplishment, because the industry changes that are happening and the fact that we're addressing the television convergence, it's such a big opportunity, and I feel like it's still early. So for me, and it's much harder, I feel like my greatest accomplishment has been the journey to date on Videology, although that chapter in that book is yet to be finished and written.
Now, I think with every successful executive, while they have a number of great accomplishments, there's always one major setback along the way that demonstrates their mettle, if you will, in terms of being able to not only grow something, but be able to overcome a particular problem or setback. So what was your setback, and how did you deal with it?
Interestingly, the setback I had at advertising.com was the same we had at Videology, which was an economic crisis. So depending on your perspective, March of 2000 was arguably the beginning of the dot-com quote-unquote implosion, with the blowing up of the business-to-consumer marketplace, as you know very well. And then that proceeded to go on throughout 2000, and then eventually we had 9/11 in 2001. And that whole time period was incredibly difficult. We lost 60% of our revenues in 5 months. It was a travesty. And what I learned from that is that the only constant in life is change. And what we realize is that the most important thing is not how right are we at all times, but how good are we at reacting to changing conditions, which will always occur. 2008 was a financial crisis in this country and a relative deep recession that was a massive impact to what we were doing at Videology. And what we had to do at Videology was we pivoted, and we literally changed course, because the existing business model, which was to aggregate original content from the studios and put it out as a destination site for consumers to watch television content, wasn't going to work. And the economic crisis of 2008 wasn't going to allow us to survive long enough to see that model through. And the way we handled it is that we changed, and we realized that there was a tremendous technological platform that we had developed for the delivery of television-based ads in an internet era, and that was the right business model to focus on. So in both cases, advertising.com and Videology, my greatest setbacks were these economic recessions or crises that radically affected our business, and in both cases, we had to pivot in a significant way, and it was our openness to being able to pivot that actually allowed us to succeed from there.
So in addition to being open to change, the quality that persisted in these setbacks was a persistence not to give up. How would you describe that, what you were thinking, how you felt when you were dealing with this?
So, as you know, success begets success. And when you're in a difficult time, you can get into a negative spiral. So the most important thing, I argue, is a positive attitude and determination. You call it persistence. Other people can call it sweat. But the belief that if I keep working at this, I understand that the world has changed and my conditions have changed, but if I can persist and not get down on what's happened, but drive through it, that was the single greatest reason for our success. Persistence on the execution path.
And many times we find that the success in dealing with a setback is actually more satisfying than the success at growing a business.
I have found that my greatest returns on emotional investment have been from the difficult times. Great companies are not defined by how things go under great circumstances. Great companies are defined by how well they react under difficult times. So from a personal point of view, as an entrepreneur like yourself, I have taken great pleasure in actually having the most difficult times and finding opportunities to survive and actually rise above. And they have been the most rewarding. Mm. They're often the most difficult when you're going through it, but if you can stay the focus and the course like you have, Dave, in all of your ventures, and the few times I've had a chance to do this, it really is quite rewarding.
It's like finishing a race.
It is like finishing the race. It feels tremendous.